How many years have you been a chaplain now?
I've served 14 years as a chaplain in the Air Force.
Is there a bittersweet quality about your last day as a chaplain?
More than anything, I think, as I've completed my 20 years of service, and that would include 7 years enlisted. I actually entered back in 1983 at the age of 18, enlisted in the Air Force, and completed 7 years, and then later in 2002 joined as a chaplain. I think it's caused me to stop and pause and reflect on all of my assignments, all of the wonderful people that I've met, that I've served with. So as I go forth, I think of all the blessings that I received from families and individuals, weddings, baptisms that I've done. Now, as I'm leaving the military, people become aware of my military experience, and they will actually seek you out as a chaplain, as a priest, bishop, and want to talk to you about some of the things that they face, that they struggle with, that they carry within them, that live within them from their war experiences.
Your responsibilities as a chaplain and your responsibilities as a bishop, do you see any connections there or differences that strike you?
What has happened in my 14 years as a chaplain and also to my enlisted years is that we go through many different types of leadership training courses, conferences that we attend, and we're evaluated by our supervisors, held to very high levels of standards. We have to do public briefings, speaking engagements to military officers that are much higher ranking than we are. And so you learn how to engage with individuals in various leadership positions. I've learned through the military to become a stronger leader. As my supervisor had me be a supervisor for other chaplains, you become responsible for very large projects where you have to network with individuals from various agencies and make sure it's a success, make sure it's done. I think the organization and the structure of it can be very beneficial in working in the church, which, you know, has a hierarchical, a similar structure. But I think at the same time, life in the military is incredibly fast-paced, and it operates under very much a rank-structured type of a movement in day-to-day decisions and the way business happens. So my hope is that as time marches forward, as a bishop, and I'm aware of these opportunities, that this will create a desire, it'll be a catalyst for me to reach out and engage with the local community to see what we can do spiritually to encourage people that suffer with PTSD and other challenges following deployments to give them hope, give them encouragement in their faith.